Today we're gonna make a sprite come to the front or to the back. Send to front, send to back. And here is this sprite we're gonna use. It's Megaman. I'm Sparckman, by the way, and welcome to this video. I took this example from the AKG2 examples. That's why Megaman is called Penguin. Call him Megaman. Oops. And the football will be the brick. So those are the two sprites we have loaded. Now, if you're not sure how to load backgrounds and sprites, check out my previous videos, or you can simply use this code. Let's make our first variable, and let's call it front equals 0. After the main loop, let's print our variable. Print front. Try it out. Here it is. Wow, that's small. I don't know if you can see that. So if front is greater than 0, front greater than 0, oh, greater than 1, then we're gonna set front equals 0 and if. Now, if the user clicks on the screen or taps on the screen, then we're going to increase the counter. If get pointer pressed, this is going to be equals 1, then we're gonna add 1 to the counter. Front equals front plus 1. Let's end if. Try it out. Hey, we're clicking and nothing is happening. What's happening? Whoa, wait a second. I typed font instead of front. Try it again. Click. Or tap on the screen. Let's change the depth of the sprite. If front equals 0. Then we're gonna set the sprite. Oops, sprite. Cannot spell sprite. Depth. The first sprite is going to be set to 1, so which is going to bring it to the front. So let's set the second sprite to back. Sprite. Wow, I cannot spell sprite again. Depth. Sprite number 2 is going to go 0, which is the back. Else. Let me just copy this, paste it. We're gonna set the second one to the front and the first sprite to back. And let's end if. Okay, so let's try it out. Whoa, we can send Mega Man behind the block and in front of the block. Wow, that was so simple. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye now.